Hey everybody, this is Shane with Lost Coast Longboarding, and today I'm going to show you how to shred a skate park on a longboard. Check it out.
Woo, that was high.
Alright, today we are in Colorado, but the skate park that we're shredding in this video is in Tulare, California. And so before we get started, I'm going to tell you about the board I use. I use a Lost Coast Longboarding deck. I like this bottlenose shape. Here's some more examples. Some benefits of this shape. You can really see the shape prevents wheel bite when you turn really sharp. And riding in the bowl, I have loose trucks, so I can make sharp turns. And this shape really helps avoid wheel bite. I use soft wheels. Some people like hard wheels in the skate park, but I think soft wheels are much smoother. Another benefit of these boards is the material. So as you can see, this is a bamboo fiberglass composite material longboard. And this is really good for many reasons. One good reason is that it's lightweight, and that really helps carry your speed and build speed. Another great aspect of this material, the bamboo fiberglass composite, is the flexibility. I'm gonna show you how flexible this material is. Granted, we're on dirt, not cement. But you're not gonna break the board. It's made to flex, and this flex really helps when you're cement surfing because you can really push into the curves and pump, and that flex helps carry your momentum and build speed. While we're skating here at this skate park, we start at the beginning, and the obstacles are small, and throughout the video, they gradually get bigger and bigger, and the last bowl at the end of the video is probably the biggest bowl that I've ever longboarded in, and it's exciting. So stay tuned, check out the whole video. I really enjoy this bowl because it's got a smooth roll in, kind of like a Twinkie shape that you can take in a couple directions. And it's a really odd shaped bowl, which has a lot of pockets. And that's really fun for surfing. It really feels like you're hitting the waves, and it's great for cement surfing. Alright, this third bowl is pretty cool. It's definitely deeper than the last two bowls, and it's fully lined in coping, which is fine for most people, but like I said, with no tail, it's hard to drop in. I started inside this bowl and kind of built up momentum, and then it went from there. It goes fast. Play fast, never change back. Calling, calling, I don't pay back, cause I'm great at that. All right, this last bowl is the fourth and the largest bowl at the Tulare Skatepark, and it's a really cool bowl. It's really big, it's really deep, and it's got multiple roll-ins, which is great for me and the longboards. This bowl is pretty big, and it was a little intimidating at first. So my first run was just me trying not to fall and seeing how fast I went. I know a lot of people are gonna say I should have my helmet on, and when we were at the skate park, I didn't have the helmet in the truck. We were just driving through the Sacramento, Tulare area, and I wasn't gonna not skate, so I skated. Check it out. All right, I didn't fall, and I'm getting comfortable with the speed, so now I gotta figure out some lines. I'm getting the hang of this. Now I'm comfortable with the speed, I'm comfortable with the lines and the turns a little bit. It's time to go fast. The skate park has huge vert, big bowls. If you're ever in Tulare, California, you gotta check it out. If you just want a new longboard, or it's time for a new one, check out lostcoastlongboarding.com. We have our latest selection of hand-painted longboards online. Each one's hand-painted by me, one of one. And if there's none on the website, send us a message. We'll be happy to get you a custom board whenever you're ready. As always, please like and subscribe, and thanks for watching. I really hope you enjoyed the video.